heart, but the very next day you gave it away.
Praise the Lord. Well, today we're just so happy to see so many of you here for our Christmas service. Today our service will be a bilingual service. I think it's been a long time since we, you know, have live interpretation. It's been a while since we are back at the fourth floor of the Emmanuel Assembly of God Sanctuary.
再一次呢, 感谢大家来到我们今天, 整个, Emmanuel Assembly 的第四楼这里聚会。
So, before we get started, we just want to say the Apostles' Creed.
聚会开始呢, 我们会一起来念使徒信经。
Alright, so because it's bilingual, so the Apostles' Creed today, we will read it in English, and then at the end of the service, when we pray the Lord's Prayer, we'll pray in Chinese.
今天是双语聚会, 所以呢, 一开始的使徒信经, 我们会用英文来念。 那到最后结束的时候, 主导文, 我们会用中文来念。
So once we start the service, then we'll hand the time to the praise and worship team. They are going to do some Christmas, familiar Christmas carols today.
那聚会刚开始的时候呢, 我们会, 我们的敬拜团会带领我们, 带大家一起来唱一些大家熟悉的圣诞歌。
All right, so that will get us into the Christmas season. Okay.
真的是感谢主我们来到这个圣诞的季节。
Shall we just stand out on our feet?
请大家起立。
And let's prepare ourselves as we start today's service.
我们预备好自己来开始今天的聚会。
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, He rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let's just pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence here in this place. Lord, we are here to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and our Savior.
祂是我们的主,
so today, may you receive all the glory and honor.
主要,
as we celebrate the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a big hand right now. Amen.
Let us receive. 起来荣耀赞美。
起来，众心上土，大家喜乐盈盈。起来，一起来，大家上我的好。来，唱见声音，天使君王降下。起来，崇拜我救主。起来，崇拜我救主。起来，崇拜我救主。
却是万王之王。
秋水跟草上
救主降生。
让赞美
worship Him for a moment. We worship You, Lord. We honor You.
主，我们敬拜你。
God, we are here to celebrate that first Christmas night.
主，我们真的是真实在这里庆祝那第一个圣诞夜晚。
What a special night that will be.
那是一个何等特别的夜晚。
For the angels have declared that glory to God in the highest.
天使欢呼说，在至高之处荣耀归于神。
And finally, peace on earth and goodwill toward men.
在地上平安归于他所喜悦的人。
Lord, we thank you, O God, for all that you have prepared in your salvation history.
主，我们为着你在救赎历史里面所预备的一切感谢你。
That today we can be gathered together to be your people.
今天我们可以一起召聚成为你的百姓。
So we pray, O God, that may the name of Jesus be high and lifted up and glorified in today's service.
主，我们祷告，在今天的聚会当中，耶稣的圣名被高高的高举起来。
And Lord, as we fix our eyes on You, then Lord, You will, Your presence and Your peace will surround us.
主啊，我们定睛在你身上，你的同在，你的平安环绕我们。
Whatever situation or difficulties we are going through,
不管我们在经历什么样子的情况，什么样子的困难
，We know, O Lord, You are with us.
我们深知主你与我们同在
Emmanuel, God with us
以马内利神与我们同在
We thank you and we commit today's service to you, O Lord
主，我们感谢你将今天的聚会交托在你手中
In Jesus' name we pray
奉耶稣的名祷告
Amen, 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 Amen Let's give glory to the Lord today, Amen
将一切荣耀归给神
Praise the Lord, Amen Before you're seated down, turn to your neighbor on your left and right and just give them a...Fist bump or celebrate Merry Christmas, all right?
坐下之前，跟旁边的人打个招呼，跟他们说圣诞快乐。
So good to hear Christmas carols again.
很高兴再次听到这些圣诞歌。
And I think you will notice together with me that all the carols have some new arrangements, right?
相信大家都听出来了，我们这些诗歌都有一些新的这个歌曲的调整。
Right, praise the Lord. I just want to tell you that our praise and worship team they have been practicing very hard for today's service.
想告诉大家的是，我们的敬拜团为了今天的聚会，他们真的是练习了很久，很努力的练习。
Because a few weeks ago they already started their practice.
好几个星期之前，他们已经在练习了。
So just help me to appreciate them and thank you for all their time and their effort.
再次感谢他们。
Praise the Lord. All right, I just want to give you some quick announcements.
这里有一些报告。
First is that there will be no on-site service next week.
那下个星期呢，在这里没有现场的聚会。
All right, so we will just screen our services over Facebook at the exact time. 2:30 for Chinese service, 5 o'clock for English service.
下个星期的聚会呢，一样就是在Facebook 直播，两点半是华文聚会，五点钟是英文聚会。
And just, second announcement, let me give you the report from last week, our initiative with Ray of Hope to bless children. We have blessed 155 children who have received gifts from us.
那跟大家做一下报告，就是我们跟这个 Ray of Hope 合作，那我们总共送出了155份的礼物给这些孩童。
So many of you were involved, right? Give yourself an encouragement, right?
很多人都参与，为自己的付出努力拍掌。
Wonderful. Now today, when you came into our hall at the entrance, we also have prepared a welcome gift for everyone.
今天当大家进入会堂的时候，我们也为大家预备了礼物。
For the families, right? We know that usually the families will cook, so we have prepared a gift pack for families that include oven gloves, a spatula spoon, and a handmade table mat.
那为如果你是一家人的话，我们为这个家庭准备了这些跟这个煮相关的这个煮东西相关的这些礼物。
And actually, this colorful table mat is made by beneficiaries from Teddy Tots.
这个是 Teddy Tots.
Teddy Tots 是一个 social enterprise.
Okay. 这个 Teddy Tots 它是他们准备的这个
table mat.
Okay.
就是okay, yeah. I think I can do it in English also. So basically, that means the ladies or the beneficiaries, right, who sew all these mats, they are either single mothers or they cannot work outside their home. They have to stay in-house in their home. And so we actually purchased these mats from them. All right? So we just wanted to also do good and at the same time give you a gift on our Christmas weekend. Then for the individuals who are here, we have prepared cookies and a very colorful flask for you.
那同样我们为这，如果说你不是家庭的话，我们也是有为你自己个人预备了一份圣诞礼物。
The cookies are baked by our own church members. We have Roslyn, I just read in English, okay? Roslyn, Su Hui, Pearl, Evelyn, my own sister Christine, all right? We have also Amanda, who also helped us to bake the cookies, and one brother Caleb, who was involved in it. Yeah.
其中一份是饼干，这饼干是我们自己教会的弟兄姐妹预备的。
So I just want to appreciate all of them and thank them.
特别感谢他们。
Now, before we have the sharing of the word, at this point, I also want to take the opportunity to thank all our volunteers, our ministry workers, who have served faithfully and tirelessly throughout this whole entire year.
那在分享话语之前呢，我想趁着这个机会，感谢我们教会的许多义工这些自愿付出的这些同工呢，真的一年来不辞劳苦的来服侍。
Okay, so we have been in as a church, meeting together for 2 years now.
我们整个教会到现在已经两年了。
But we still don't have our own office.
我们还没有自己的办公室。
We have a couple of part-time staff.
我们有一些部分时间的同工。
But majority of everyone is a volunteer.
但是大部分的人都是自愿的义工。
That means they have their own day jobs.
换句话说，他们本身自己有其他的工作。
So every week when you come to church, whatever you see, all right, is a lot of effort that is put in by them. And so I just want to specially name, to thank the ushers, the security people.
每个星期大家来参加聚会都是很多，都是因为他们的帮忙，特别感谢我们的招待员，我们的保安人员。
Of course, our musicians and singers.
还有我们的乐团歌手。
We also have our tech team or in IT team who manages the app.
还有我们的技术同工管理整个应用程序的等等。
Primarily, Jane and James who are helping us.
特别是 James 还有 Jane 帮助我们。
And then we also have our audio and visual team.
还有我们的音响的视觉效果的这个同工。
And our hospitality team as well.
还有我们的接待同工。
They are the ones who came early today to pack the gift pack for all everyone.
今天他们很早就来到这里为大家包装这个礼物。
Also, I want to thank all the church board, of course.
还要特别来感谢教会的董事会
，and many many others behind the many other behind the scenes volunteers who help us in their own way.
还有很多在幕后帮助我们的同工们。
One very special group are actually our children's church teachers and workers.
还有一个很特别的群组就是我们的儿童教会的老师。
Because you actually don't get to see them because they are usually at the second floor serving the children.
一般上他们都在二楼服侍这些孩童，所以大家不常有机会看到他们。
So, a big hand, a round of applause for everyone. Thank you for serving the Lord and Christ Gospel Church throughout this year, right?
再次感谢大家这两年来这样子的服侍这个教会。
Amen. Praise the Lord. Right, today we have a full crowd and it's what an amazing thing. I see some new friends. I also see old friends.
今天我们这里坐满了人，看到一些熟悉的脸孔，也看到一些新的脸孔。
I just want to welcome everyone.
想要欢迎每一位。
Amen, amen.
Amen.
Right, now, at the end of the service, you can drop your offering at the offering box, or you can also scan the QR code and give your offerings for today's service, okay?
聚会结束之后，如果你要透过奉献箱奉献的话，那奉献箱在后面，那你也可以用其他的 方式来奉献，那是在我们的投影片上面。
Alright, praise the Lord. Now today I want to share a sermon.
今天我想跟大家分享一篇信息。
And I've specially titled it as the Royal Family.
我把这个标题特别定成君王家族。
Now, it's not your usual Christmas sermon.
是大家不常听到的一种圣诞节的信息。
Because I'm going to share from Matthew chapter 1 verses 1 to 17, which is the genealogy of the birth of Jesus.
因为我要从马太福音第一章1到17节来分享，这个部分记载的是耶稣的家谱。
Now many of us are familiar with what we call the nativity story.
很多人都很熟悉耶稣诞生的故事。
Now this story, what will immediately come to your mind?Will be an angel appearing to Mary, who was a virgin, and telling her that you will be with child.
很多人可能立刻想到的就是一个天使在童女玛利亚面前出现，告诉她说你会怀孕生子。
And then, through different circumstances, she came to a place where she was about to give birth, but there was no room, for the baby. There was no crib for the bed, and she had to give birth in a manger.
那经过很多种不同的环境之后呢，他最后来到一个没有婴儿床的地方生下小孩。
And so the picture we have of the nativity story is exactly this picture that I've just shown you on the slide.
所以我们对诞生的故事的了解，就是像我们在荧幕上看到的这个画面一样。
You know, maybe you think three wise men came and then presented gifts to baby Jesus.
你可能认为是三个智者送礼物到这个婴儿耶稣面前。
But I want to tell you that the gospel actually presents a bigger and a greater nativity story than what was commercially publicized to all of us.
但是呢，我想告诉大家，福音书向我们呈现的其实是比整个商业告诉我们的这个诞生故事更加的大，更加的广。
Because the gospel is presenting the story about a king who is to rule the world forever.
因为呢，福音所谈到的是有一个君王，他要永远的掌管世界。
In other words, now I want to read to you what foremost New Testament scholar N.T. Wright wrote in his recent Instagram post.
我想跟大家分享一个非常出名的新约学者赖特，他在他最近的 Instagram 上面所分享的一段话。
And he said this: Our culture has downgraded the Christmas stories into sweet little songs and primary school nativity plays.
他说，我们的文化把圣诞故事缩小了，只剩下好听的歌曲和小学里的圣诞剧。
He said, but the birth of a baby who will inherit the throne of ancestor David announces the start of a revolution.
但是有一名婴儿诞生，他要接续他祖先大卫的宝座，这样子的宣告已经开始了一场革命。
He says, nothing will ever be the same again.
他说，一切都不再一样了。
Anyone claiming David's kingdom is throwing down a challenge to the rulers of the world.Whether in the first century or in the 21st century.
无论是在第一世纪还是第二十一世纪，凡承认大卫国度的人都是在向世界的掌权者发出挑战。
So today we want to look at Matthew chapter 1, but because of time constraint, I will only read to you verse 1 and verse 17.
那我们今天会来看马太福音第一章，因为时间的关系，只会来看一节跟十七节。
It says here in verse 1, the book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ,The son of David, the son of Abraham.
一章一节说，亚伯拉罕的后裔，大卫的子孙，耶稣基督的家谱。
And later on, I'm going to break it down word by word. Okay, Jesus Christ, son of David, son of Abraham.
那等一下我会一一的来看，耶稣基督还有大卫的子孙，亚伯拉罕的后裔。
So let's look at verse 17.
看十七节。
So all the generations from Abraham to David were 14 generations, and from David to the deportation to Babylon, 14 generations, and from the deportation to Babylon to the Christ, 14 generations.
这样，从亚伯拉罕到大卫共有十四代，从大卫到迁至巴比伦的时候也有十四代，从迁至巴比伦的时候到基督又有十四代。
Now, when the Bible repeats something again and again, we have to pay attention.
圣经不断地重复一些字眼的时候，就是我们要留心的时候了。
So what can we see as unique characteristics of this genealogy?
在这个家谱当中，我们可以看到哪一些 特别的地方呢？
The first thing I want to share with you is that Matthew's genealogy divided the more than 40 over names, okay, into three groups of 14.
首先呢，我要跟大家分享的就是马太的家谱呢，把整个家谱分成三个十四代。
From Abraham to David, 14 generations. David to the deportation to Babylon, 14 generations. And deportation back again to the birth of the Christ, 14 generations.
从亚伯拉罕到大卫是十四代，大卫到迁至巴比伦的时候又是十四代，这个从巴比伦回来，然后呢到基督又是十四代。
Now if I were to just put it on the table, I put it up for you, it will look something like this.
如果把这个名字整理一下，差不多就是这个样子。
And don't worry, just, you know, I'm not going to read through all the names.
不用担心，我不会把每一个名字念出
来。But I want to show you that every column of 14 has the name David.
但是我想大家看到的是，每一栏就是十四个名字里面，每一栏都有一个名字是大卫。
Okay, so why is so David's name is mentioned three times? David, David, David.
换句话说，大卫的名字被提到了三次，大卫，大卫，大卫。
And we also know, if you are familiar with the Old Testament, that Matthew actually intentionally omitted some names so that he could achieve 14 names.
如果你对旧约熟悉的话，你会发现其实马太他是刻意不提一些名字，好让他整个一栏里面是刚好十四个名字。
So therefore, you know that the 14 is intentional, but why?
换句话说，你就知道这十四是马太刻意这样子列出来的，但是原因是什么呢？
Because, which again, that's why I encourage people to go to seminary, the Hebrew word for David, okay, the consonants are dalet, vav, and dalet. That's why it's David, okay?And each consonant in the Hebrew character has a number. Dalet is 4, Vav is 6. So if you add Dalet, Vav, and Dalet together, you get 14.
那如果你去神学院学了希伯来文的话，你就知道说大卫他的这个名字是三个字母所组成的 Dalet, Vav, 还有 Dalet。那 Dalet 它也每一个希伯来字母它代表的是一个数字。那 Dalet 它是四 ，Vav 就是六，所以四加六再加四，总共就是十四。
Praise the Lord! You know why Xiao Ming can interpret like this? Because we are in the same school.
Xiao Ming 可以这样子翻译，因为我们同一个学校。
And this semester, both of us took Hebrew.
这个学期我们刚好都在学希伯来文。
That's right, exactly right. He understands. So Jesus.Why 14 generations? It is Matthew shouting to his audience, this is the son of David. This is the Davidic king that is to rule the world.
为什么十四呢？马太就是用这种方式向他的听众，向他的读者来呼喊说，这就是大卫，这就是要掌管世界的那个君王。
So Jesus' name, Jesus, means Yahweh saves.
耶稣这个名字，他的意思就是亚卫拯救的意思。
He was called the Christ or Messiah, which is the expectation of the Jewish people for a savior, for a king who will rule and will be the hope of their future.
他是弥赛亚或者就是基督，因为他就是犹太人所盼望的那一位，所期待要掌管他们的那一位。
And then Jesus was called the son of David because he was the direct descendant of King David who will inherit David's throne.
耶稣被称为大卫的子孙，因为他这表示说他是直接从大卫那个血脉这样子下来的，表示说他是一个合法的君王，可以坐在宝座上的。
And then Jesus was called the son of Abraham because God promised Abraham that through him and his seed, one seed, okay, God is going to bless the nations of the world.
那他为什么被称为亚伯拉罕的后裔呢？因为神应许亚伯拉罕说，透过你和你的后裔，这个后裔指的是一个人，透过这个后裔，列国都要蒙福。
So who is that seed?
那个后裔是谁呢？
Jesus Christ.
就是耶稣基督。
So not only is he the king who will rule the world, he is a king who will bless all the nations of the world.
他不只是掌管世界的君王，他还是要赐福列国的一个君王。
That is what Matthew is trying to communicate to us.
这就是马太想要向我们表达的。
So 14 is significant.
十四它非常的重要。
Now second point of this genealogy.
那关于这个族谱的第二个特色呢
？Is that it includes women in the lineage of Jesus.
就是在耶稣的这个家谱当中。包括了纳入了女人。
Now in the Old Testament, when you read genealogies, you seldom see names of women being mentioned.
如果你读旧约，你看到谈到家谱的时候，其实很少有女人的名字。
So therefore, you know that Matthew is intentional in wanting to include the names of these women in his genealogy.
所以你就知道说，马太这么写的时候，他是刻意的要把这个女人列入家谱里面。
Because in the time of Jesus, there was already increasing marginalization and abuse of women.
因为在耶稣的时代开始，其实女人已经越来越被边缘化，甚至受到虐待。
The coming of Jesus as king was to restore the personal equality and dignity of women.
耶稣来做君王，他是要恢复女人的平等地位和尊严。
So I just want to share with you four names, four women in this genealogy. The first is Tamar.
这家谱里面有四个女人的名字，第一个就是塔玛。
Tamar was a proselyte, which means she wasn't originally a Jew, but she was converted to the Jewish faith.
塔玛他本身不是犹太人，但是呢，他后来皈依犹太教，就是信奉犹太教了。
But she was wrongfully denied of her right to motherhood by the deceitfulness of men.
但是她受到不公义的对待，因为男人的这个狡猾和诡诈，失去做一名母亲的权利。
Her father-in-law Judah was supposed to promise the third youngest son to her.
她的公公，也就是犹大。应许说，其实要将最小的儿子给他做丈夫。
But Judah did not keep his promise.
但是呢，犹大没有信守他的诺言。
And so Tamar had to disguise herself as a prostitute in order to be with child.
因此呢，塔玛她必须打扮成妓女，为了让自己可以怀孕。
And for that, Matthew puts her name in the genealogy.
因为这个缘故，马太把她的名字放在家谱里面了。
Because Tamar was more righteous.Than an Israelite, which is Judah.
因为他嘛比以色列民，也就是犹大更加的公义。
Then you have Rahab, the second woman.
那第二个女人就是拉合。
You can find that in verse 5, the first part.
这是第五节前半部。
Now, Rahab was a Canaanite woman. She was a Canaanite prostitute in the city of Jericho.
拉合是耶利哥城迦南地的妓女。
And if you know the story in the Old Testament, how when Joshua, before he conquered Jericho, he sent spies into Jericho, and Rahab was the prostitute who took care. She lied in order to protect the spies so that she could save them.
那如果你熟悉旧约的故事的话，你知道说在约书亚进攻耶利哥城之前，他先派出探子。那拉合就是在耶利哥城保护那两个探子性命的那个妓女，她是用说谎的方式保护了这两个人的性命。
You know, Rahab displayed faith, extraordinary faith, in contrast to the generation who wandered in the wilderness because they didn't have faith in God and they perished and died.
拉合所展现的是非凡的信心。他的对比是这些没有信心结果在旷野灭绝的以色列世代。
Then you have the third woman, Ruth.
第三个女人是路德。
Ruth was a Moabitess.
路德是一个摩押女子。
Again, not an Israelite, right?
同样的是外邦人，不在以色列境内。
But the story is that Ruth clung faithfully to Naomi, and in contrast to the unfaithfulness of Israel in the time of the judges.
但是呢，这个路德是忠心的，紧紧跟随着拿奥米。他对比的是士师时代那些不忠心的以色列民。
Right? Then you have the fourth woman, Bathsheba.
第四个女人拔示巴。
But interestingly, in the genealogy, Matthew did not mention her name, but rather mentioned her as the wife of the Uriah the Hittite.
很有趣的，在整个家谱里面，其实马太没有列出他的名字，但是他怎么形容他的？他说他是赫人乌利亚的妻子。
Because this is to contrast Uriah the Hittite's faithfulness and loyalty and integrity versus David's sinfulness and adultery with Bathsheba.
这是要做出一个对比，对比的是赫人乌利亚他的忠诚、他的忠心，跟大卫他的不忠，然后跟拔示巴犯奸淫。
So you say, Pastor, why are you trying to show us?
他说，你们可能会问牧师啊，你到底想告诉我们什么
？I'm trying to show you that Rahab and Ruth were Gentiles.
我想告诉你的是，拉合跟路德他们是外邦人。
Tamar, Rahab, and Bathsheba were women with questionable moral behaviors.
塔玛、拉合还有拔示巴都是这个道德值得怀疑的女人。
So we see that in Jesus' royal lineage is actually comprised of men and women, Jews and Gentiles, bad kings, faithful men, unfaithful men, sinners, adulterers, adulteresses, and heroes.
所以我们就看到耶稣的王室血统包括了男人和女人，犹太人和外邦人，然后呢，坏的君王，犯奸淫的人，忠诚的人，不忠诚的人，还有妓女，甚至啊，还有一些英雄人物。
This tells us that God's saving grace through Jesus Christ covers all humanity.
换句话说，借着耶稣基督这个拯救的恩典，是临到所有的人类的。
Not just to the Jewish people.
不单单是犹太人。
But also to the Gentiles.
同样也是给外邦人的。
Not just to men, but also to women.
不只是男人，同样有女人。
And not just to faithful men like Boaz, but also unfaithful men like Judah.
同样的，不只是给忠诚的人，比如说波阿斯，同样也给不忠诚的人，比如说犹大。
Not just to righteous men, but also to unrighteous, sinful men.
不只是给公义的人，也给不公义犯罪的人。
In fact, you see that all of humanity is united in the family of God through Jesus Christ, by grace through faith.
你看到借着耶稣，这个因着信心，因着恩典，所有的人可以进入到耶稣的家谱里面。
So now, I've shown you how through the generations you come to the birth of Jesus.
我们看到说，透过这个不同的世代，怎么看到耶稣的诞生
？But that didn't stop there.
但是，整个故事不是停在耶稣的诞生。
The genealogy of Jesus continues through his church.
耶稣的这个家谱是持续下去的，是到教会当中。
Are you with me? So all before Christ links to Christ. Everyone after Christ links to Christ as well.
基督之前的连接到基督，基督之后的人同样连接到基督。
So you can say from the beginning Abraham to David, 14 generations. But from David to Christ, 14 generations. You can look at it as now Christ's first coming. All right, he came. So all before him to his first coming is joined to him. But Christ is returning again.And this time, it is for everyone who came after his first coming.
你可以看到这个不同的十四代，他们就连接到耶稣基督，就是耶稣的第一次来到世界上。但是呢，耶稣基督还要再来，那他再来的时候，就要将耶稣基督之后的人连接到他。
If I can put it this way, Jesus came from a virgin, first coming, and he's coming for a virgin bride.In his second coming,
你可以说耶稣第一次来的时候是透过童贞女来到世界上，但是呢，他第二次，也就是他再来的时候，他是为了一个童贞女的一个教会而来。
So before the first Christmas, the coming of Jesus,
就是耶稣来到世界上之前的第一个圣诞节之前
，the tabernacle or the temple was the place where heaven meets earth.
会幕或者圣殿是天与地联合的地方
，because that is the place where God dwells.
因为那就是神所居住的地方。
But the tabernacle and the temple was always a temporary arrangement until the fulfillment of the true Messiah or Son of God, who will unite heaven and earth.
但是呢，不管是会幕，不管是圣殿，都只是一个暂时性的一个安排。 要等到什么时候呢？等到真正要成就应许的那位基督、那位弥赛亚来到的时候，他乃是真正联合天与地的那一位。
The true union that will last for all eternity, the union between God and man, needed time to be born, and that is in that person called Jesus Christ.
真正的联合，这个联合是到永永远远的，那只有透过那真正的人，也就是耶稣基督才能够成就。
So this union of Christ and the church is, you can say, is a culmination of the restored relationship between God and man.
你可以说这个基督跟教会的联合就像是神与人结合的一个表征。
Alright, so let me share with you some verses and it will become clear.
跟大家分享一些经文，你可能就会清楚了。
Look at Matthew chapter 1 and verse 23.
来看马太福音第一章二十三节。
Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us.
必有童女怀孕生子，人要称他的名为以马内利。以马内利翻出来就是神与我们同在。
Now, if this concept of God being with man and uniting with man, okay, this concept.Remember I told you it's like a tabernacle? It is echoed in the New Testament. That means Paul picks up this story, this narrative, and he says it in Ephesians chapter 1.
这个神与人的联合的这个概念在新约里面是不断的回想，不断的重复出现的。那保罗呢就在以弗所书一章这边表达了出来。
Let's look at verse 9, Ephesians 1.
来看第九节
Making known to us the mystery of his will according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ, okay, as a plan for the fullness of time to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth.
都是照他自己所预定的美意，叫我们知道他旨意的奥秘，要照所安排的，在日期满足的时候，使天上地上的一切所有的都在基督里同归于一。
So God, we can consider God as heaven.
你可以说神是天。
And he has longed for years and centuries, longed to unite with earth, with man.
他极度渴望，很长的一段时间，他非常的渴望可以与人结合。
In the Old Testament, a tabernacle and a temple.
在旧约当中，他呈现的方式就是会幕、圣殿。
God patiently waited and waited and waited.
神充满耐心的等待。
Until the birth of His Son Jesus.
直到他的儿子耶稣基督的诞生。
Until God embodies in a human.
直到神取了人的肉身。
So that through Christ, he can unite heaven and earth.
好叫因着耶稣基督，他可以叫天跟地结合而为一。
Now the concept of union is something that is already shared with all of us in Genesis chapter 1 and 2.
这合而为一的概念其实在创世纪一章二章已经跟我们分享到了。
Because God created Adam and Eve,A man and a woman, and told them that the two shall become one flesh.
因为神创造亚当夏娃，然后告诉他们说，二人要成为一体。
So, the relationship of a man and woman being in union in marriage is a picture that God leaves behind on earth to constantly remind mankind that there will come a day where heaven and earth will be united as one.
男人跟女人在婚姻当中的结合，其实就是上帝放在地上的一个象征，让人家看到说，将来有一天天跟地要这样子的合而为一。
How is God going to achieve that?
神怎么做到这一点呢
？By having His Son Jesus to be born,
他让他的儿子耶稣基督诞生
，and birthing forth the church,
然后呢使教会诞生
，that includes all men and women, Jews and Gentiles.
这教会是包括所有的男人、女人、犹太人、外邦人。
And then putting them together as a bride and a bridegroom.
然后呢，把他们放在一起，成为新郎新妇。
So that the church can be united with God through Jesus Christ.
好让教会可以因着耶稣基督与神结合。
That is really the big picture of the gospel story.
这就是福音的故事里面的整个大画面。
And this is the big purpose of the celebration of Christmas.
这就是欢庆圣诞节的最大的一个目的。
It is not just for us to have a small little nativity play.
不是让我们有一些很简单的一些圣诞剧而已。
So let me just read to you this verse in 2 Corinthians 11 verse 2 to 3.
来看一下哥林多后书十一章二节。
The apostle Paul understands his apostolic ministry to be doing exactly that.
保罗他明白他身为使徒的这个使命。
He says, I feel a divine jealousy for you since I betrothed you to one husband to present you as a pure virgin to Christ.
我为你们起的愤恨原是神那样的愤恨。因为我曾把你们许配给一个丈夫，要把你们如同贞洁的童女献给基督。
Paul's ministry to build a church，
保罗建立教会的这个使命
，has only one purpose，
只有一个目的
，to prepare the bride for the bridegroom，
预备新妇为了献给新郎
，so that all can be united with God through Christ。
好让所有人可以借着耶稣基督与神结合。
Now you and I, brothers and sisters, we are the church.
各位弟兄姐妹，我们就是教会。
So one way of looking at and celebrating Christmas is to actually celebrate the birth of our bridegroom, or you can say, is to celebrate our own wedding.
所以呢，庆祝圣诞节，你可以这样子来看，就是庆祝我们的新郎诞生，或者说。欢庆我们自己的婚礼
，So we should really, really be happy.
所以我们真的是应该感到欢喜
，Because everyone who is about to get married in the preparation for the wedding day will be full of joy.
因为要准备结婚的新人在准备婚礼的时候都是满了喜乐的
，It's great excitement.
是非常兴奋的。
And let me tell you this one more good news, and that is whether we are married today or unmarried.
再告诉大家一个好消息，不管今天你是不是在婚姻的状态里面
，All of us can participate in the joy of this cosmic wedding。
我们所有人都可以参与这个宇宙性的婚宴。
Why is it cosmic？
为什么是宇宙性的呢
？Because it's not just a small wedding of a man and a woman。
因为它不只是一个男人和一个女人的一个小型的婚礼。
It is the wedding of heaven and earth。
它是一个天跟地的结合的一个婚礼
，A union of all peoples of all tongues and tribes with God，
是所有的族群、所有的族类、所有的百姓跟神的一个结合。
And so when we think of this phrase, Emmanuel, God with us，
所以我们想到这个词的时候，以马内利，
神与
我们同在。
Then we can remember that Christ, His presence and love fills our hearts when we are lonely。
我们就知道说，当我们孤单的时候，神的慈爱必能够满足，使我们的心温暖。
Because he is our bridegroom，
因为他是我们的新郎。
His arms will shelter us in the midst of storms，
在这个风暴当中，他的双手会护庇我们。
His voice guides us when we go through the valley and dark nights，
他的声音在黑暗当中引导我们前进。
But you know what Paul says in 2 Corinthians 11, the next verse, verse 3?
但是你知道吗？保罗在下一节哥林多后书二章十一章三节的时候说到
，He warns the church, Corinthians. He warns the Corinthian church.
他这样子的警告哥林多教会。
He said, "But I am afraid that as the serpent deceived Eve by his cunning, your thoughts will be led astray from a sincere and pure devotion to Christ."
我只怕你们的心或偏于邪，失去那像基督所存一清洁的心，就像蛇用诡诈有诱惑了夏娃一样。
It was meant to be a sincere, a pure wedding or union between the church and Christ.
本来这应该是一个像基督一种纯洁合一的一种心的一个结合。
But many times Paul says, the cares of this life.
但是保罗很多次提到说，因为在世上的顾虑。
Maybe offenses that we have with one another，
或者是彼此之间的一些冒犯
，or the deceitfulness of riches，
或者说这个人的这个邪恶
，right？Our pursuit for material things，
我们对物质的追求
，it distracts us from that pure devotion
to our bridegroom.
他使我们分心了，不能够专心的向基督献上纯一清洁的心。
And causes us to have burdens that we carry in life because we are worried about tomorrow, we are worried about our livelihood.
让我们身上背负了重担，因为我们担忧的是明天，担忧的是我们的生计。
And so after a while, we dropped out of church.
所以不久后我们就离开了教会。
We get jaded with our faith and our Christianity.
那我们的整个基督教信仰就变得
累了，
就疲累了。
Because we get hurt.
因为我们受伤了。
But this Christmas,
但是呢，这样子的一个圣诞节，
let's come back to what Paul says, a simple, sincere devotion to Christ.
让我们回到保罗所说的，向基督存啊，纯一清洁的心。
So as I bring this message to a close, okay?
在结束之前呢，
let's summarize what we have seen today.
我们来总结一下今天所看到的。
From the genealogy, 14 is very important because 14 tells us that Jesus is the Davidic king. He is also the son of Abraham who will bless all the nations.
在这个家谱里面呢，十四这个数字是非常重要的，因为它让我们看到说耶稣是大卫的后裔，同时也是赐福给列国的亚伯拉罕的子孙。
Second thing we saw today was that his salvation grace extends to every man and woman, every Jew and Gentile, sinners or heroes.
那第二点我们看到说他的拯救的恩典呢，是扩展到所有的男人女人犹太人外邦人罪人还有伟人。
And then the third point was that through our union with JesusWe are all united with God.
第三点，我们看到说，借着与耶稣的联合，我们与上帝联合。
So truly, the union between Adam and Eve in Eden can be restored through Jesus Christ.
因此呢，在伊甸园里面，亚当跟夏娃的这个联合呢，是可以借着耶稣基督重新恢复。
So what is this picture here? It's a picture of God the Father.
这里的画面是什么呢？就是天父
，Eternal Father，
这个永恒的父
，wants all of his creation to be part of his family，
要所有他的受造物归入他的家庭里。
And so, like a proud father, he rejoices at the day of his son's wedding，
就好像一个非常得意的父亲在儿子的婚礼的时候，他感到满心的欢喜。
So the son is standing there at the front of the stage.
他的儿子站在台前。
Then another father, proud father, walking down the aisle with his daughter.
另外一个骄傲的父亲牵着他的女儿步入礼堂。
And then hands the daughter to the man.
然后呢，把他的女儿交给这个男人。
So the father of both families rejoiced to see the union between their son and daughter.
两个家族的人都是满心的欢喜，看到这对新人的结合。
So we are really talking about how God, in His great plan, grand plan, wants to welcome all of us into His royal family.
所以我们就看到上帝在他这个荣耀伟大的计划当中，怎么样子的欢迎每一位进入到他这个王族的家族里面。
And this cosmic wedding is going to be more glorious than the most expensive weddings in the world.
那这个宇宙性的婚礼呢，是比世界上任何最昂贵的婚礼更加的荣耀。
So to prepare this message, right, I went to go and ask someone to give me some research and help me.To find what is the most expensive royal weddings in recent times.
那因为准备这个信息的关系，我请一些人帮我找一些资料，就是最近几年、几十年最昂贵的婚礼是哪一些。
So Prince William and Kate Middleton's wedding in 2011 cost $40 million.
2011年，威廉王子和凯特王妃的婚礼呢，总共耗资4000万。
But that's nothing compared to Princess Diana and Prince Charles' wedding in the 80s, which cost almost or more than $70 million.
但是呢，这跟查理斯还有查理王子还有戴安娜王妃的这个婚礼比起来呢，还是小巫见大巫。他们的婚礼总共是花了7000万的美金。
These are weddings that we are all familiar with. Royal weddings, I mean.
这些都是我们非常熟悉的这个王族婚姻。
But the cosmic royal wedding that we are talking about，
但是我们所谈到的这个宇宙性的这个婚宴
，will be far greater and far bigger，
是更加伟大、更加的大的。
Because it involves the entire world，
因为它涉及的是整个世界。
And the celebrations will be for all eternity。
那整个欢庆呢是持续到永永远远的。
Because finally Emmanuel, God, is able to be with man。
因为终于以马内利的神可以与人联合。
No longer through a tabernacle or a temple。
不再是透过会幕，不再是透过圣殿。
And regardless of man or woman, Jews or Gentiles。
不管是男人、女人、犹太人或者外邦人。
So I want to read to you this last verse in Revelation chapter 22 and verse 7 and 17.
来看一下最后一个经文，在启示录二十二章七节。
It says, "And behold, I am coming soon," Jesus says.
耶稣说：“看哪，我必快来。”
So what does, how does the church respond? The church or the Spirit and the Bride says, "Come."
教会怎么回应呢？圣灵跟心腹都说：“来。”
And let the one who hears say, "Come."And let the one who is thirsty come. Let the one who desires take the water of life without price.
听见的人也该说来，口渴的人也当来，愿意的人都可以白白取生命的水喝。
So I just want the musicians to come now. So this is what Christmas is really about.
这就是圣诞节的意义。
Yes, we have all our shopping and we have all our meals and our fellowship.
的确，我们可以去购物啊，去团契吃饭。
It's the end of the year, you know, people take time off to be with the family.
是一年的年终，人家花时间跟家人一同相处。
All that is wonderful.
这些都非常的美好。
But we must not forget the bigger picture of what Christ's birth really means.
但是我们不可以忘记这个更大的画面，到底基督诞生是什么意思？
So as we right now we're going to enter into a time where we prepare ourselves to partake of the Holy Communion.
我们现在预备自己的心来领受圣餐。
Our union with Jesus.
我们来思想我们与耶稣基督的联合。
Is represented by a cup and bread.
是透过饼跟杯来代表。
And Paul says this. Paul says.I am afraid, I was so afraid that you would lose that simplicity and the sincere devotion to Christ.
保罗说，我深怕你们的心会失去对基督的那种纯一清洁。
So I'm asking you, as we prepare our hearts, and then the singers are going to sing, as we prepare our hearts to partake of communion, that we come back today, on this Christmas day, we come back and return back to God,With a sincere and pure devotion to our bridegroom.
所以我们在预备心领受圣餐的时候，我想鼓励大家再次转向基督，是带着纯一清洁的心转向这位新郎。
No matter what heavy burdens we may be carrying,
不管我们身上负着什么样子的重担。
Yeah, the ushers can help me to pass the elements, right? Make sure everyone have one. I also need to have one, Xiaoming as well.But no matter what burdens we carry, or what worries we have about 2022,
不管我们有什么样子的重担，或者说我们对2022年感到怎么样子的忧虑，
our bridegroom covers us.
我们的新郎他遮蔽我们，
protects us，
保护我们，
comforts us，
安慰我们。
His voice brings clarity and light into every darkness.
他的声音在每一个黑暗当中带来光明，带来清晰。
So let's return to him.
让我们归向他，转向他。
And let's have the musicians and singers to lead us in this song. You just remain seated and let's allow the lyrics of the song to minister to us as we prepare ourselves to eat of this communion.
一起让这个歌词来服侍我们每一个人。
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long
No matter how 2021 has been for you,
不管2021年对你来讲是怎么样的一年，
right now at this moment we are with the Lord.
在这个时刻我们是与主同在。
His presence is very close to us.
他的同在就靠近我们。
So we just still our hearts, close our eyes.
我们真的是让我们闭上眼睛。
And just quietly in your own way,Just come back to that pure, sincere devotion to Him.
回到对他的这个最忠诚的这个摆上。
And let's let go of all our worries and anxiety.
放掉我们的一切忧虑。
Or any fear that we may have.
或者你感到的害怕。
Sadness because of broken relationships.
可能是关系的破裂带来的忧伤
hurts because of offenses
可能是冒犯带来的伤害
let's just release them right now
现在就释放他们
as we come to this sacred moment with the Lord
在这神圣与主面对面的时刻
knowing that he loves us
晓得他爱我们
he embraces us
他拥抱我们
Because he wants to unite us with God.
因为他要让我们与神联合。
So we thank you, Jesus.
耶稣，我们感谢你。
That all men and women,
所有的男人、女人
Jews and Gentiles,
犹太人、外邦人
Broken people,
破碎的人
Sinners,
罪人
Lord, we can be united.By grace through faith.
主啊，今天可以借着恩典，因着信心，我们可以再次与神联合。
We can participate in this royal wedding.
我们可以参与在这个王主的婚宴里。
To be part of your royal family.
可以成为这个皇室家族的一份子。
And Lord, we just pray today.
主啊，我们祷告。
That your grace.
求你的恩典。
Your forgiveness.
你的饶恕。
Lord, your presence
主啊，你的同在
will heal our hearts.
医治我们的心
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, the body of Jesus was broken for us. Let's unite with him and be in union with him through this act of eating the bread and drinking the cup.
各位弟兄姐妹，让我们透过这个领圣餐的方式与基督联合。
Let's drink of the cup, the blood of Jesus was shed for us.
我们也喝这杯耶稣的宝血为我们而流。
Lord, we celebrate your death on the cross, your resurrection from the dead.
我们欢庆你在十字架上的受死，你从死里复活。
We celebrate that you are now ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father.
我们欢庆你今天已经升上天，坐在父上帝的右边。
And you will return for your bride.
你必为着你的心腹再来。
I thank you in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Shall we just stand on our feet? And let's sing this song.
一起起立，我们来唱这首歌。
Oh, hear the angels' voices on high.
Oh,
sing it with all our heart. Let me give you a prayer of blessing for this Christmas.
让我为大家来祝福。
This Christmas, may all of you and your family who need a miracle be blessed.
在这圣诞，愿你或你的家庭，如果你需要神迹的话，愿你蒙福。
May all who are unwell or weak be strengthened.
不舒服的、生病的，你们得着力量。
And those of you who have heavy burdens, may your load be lightened.
如果身体带着重担的，愿这个担子可以轻省。
May this Christmas be filled with happiness and joy for all of you.
愿这个圣诞节使你的生命充满着喜乐。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord praise. Amen. Glory.
献上我们的赞美。
Hallelujah. Amen. Before we go, let's just pray the Lord's Prayer together in Chinese.
那我们离开之前，一起用中文来。用来念主导文。
It is all on the screen. Let's just say now. 我们
在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣。愿你的国降临。愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们。免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债。不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的。直到永远。
Amen. So the Lord bless you and keep you.
愿耶和华看顾你，保守你。
And the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you.
愿耶和华向你仰脸，赐你平安。
And the Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
他向你仰脸，赐你平安。
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ.
愿主耶稣基督的恩惠。
And the love of God.
天父的慈爱。
And the communion of the Holy Spirit.
圣灵的感动交通。
Be with you all.
与我们众人同在。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church, we cannot end our Christmas service without wishing one another Merry Christmas.
让我们一起来祝贺彼此圣诞快乐。再次感谢大家来参加今天的聚会。
Like, don't be in a hurry to leave.
那也请大家不要急着离开。
Because we only have two lifts, so let's just settle down a little bit, you know, fellowship a while, and slowly, slowly, you know, we let whoever that needs to go go first, okay?
好，我们可以坐下来先团契一下，慢慢的一些人潮啊。
Remember next week there's no on-site service.
记得下个星期没有在这里的聚会。
God bless you. Okay.
上帝祝福大家。